Hello and welcome back. In this video, we will learn about loops and take a look at a couple of different ways to do loop in JavaScript. So loops allow you to run same code multiple times. So let's say you want to print out numbers from 1 to 100. Instead of printing it out one by one on separate lines, you can take advantage of loops, which will help you do it really quickly. So let's take a look at some example. So to print out numbers from 1 to 100, obviously one way to do is by doing console log 1 and then do the 2 and then 3, and then basically we can keep doing this 100 times, right? So clearly this is not the efficient way to do this. Instead, what we can do is take advantage of loops. So the most commonly used loops in JavaScript is called a for loop. So the way for loops work is basically we create for and we add a bracket. And then here we're going to create a variable. We can assign this variable many names, and this typically you will assign it I, that's the standard. I'm going to do I is equal to 0, that's the 0th index. Instead, or I can do from 1 or 2 depending on whatever the situation is. In this scenario, I'm going to do it from 0 and add this semicolon over here to separate my next condition. Then I'm going to say I is less than 100. Basically, it's going to keep increasing until I is less than 100. Then I'm going to add again semicolon and I will do I plus plus. So I know this is a bit complicated if this is the first time you're looking at it, but basically what we are doing is creating a variable called I, and then we are assigning a value 0. And then we are saying, hey, keep on looping until the value is less than 100. So here we are saying keep increasing the value by 1. So the first time it will loop, the value would be from 0, it will change to 1. Then it will change to 2, and then it will keep doing it until the value is 99. When it's 100, it will stop. And we'll add our curly brackets here, and then I'll print it out, do console.log, do I. Now, if I hit run, there you go. We just ran from 0 all the way till 99. Awesome. So how quick that was. Instead of doing one by one, we just did this in like, what, 3 lines? So that's how efficient for loops are. It helps you do this looping condition where you don't have to print or do something again and again and again. Now, most commonly loops are used with arrays. So to give you a more practical example, if we go to our previous example where we created array, this planets array, I'm going to do this, paste it over here. Now let's say if you want to print out planets, all these planets one by one, so we can take advantage of arrays here. Now, obviously, we can do this like we just looked at before by doing, let's say, planets, and I can assign the 0th index, and I do again, I will do 1, do again, then do 2. Obviously, if I run this, so this will work. We have this all 3 printed out. I'm going to comment this out for now. But instead of doing this, let's say if this keeps added and we have way more planets, let's assume. So instead of doing that, what we can do is take advantage of for loop again. So I'm going to do for. And then over here, I'll say var I equals 0, I is less than. In this scenario, we don't know, let's say, the length of the array. So to get the length of the array, we can do planets.length. So this will give us the length. So in this case, the length is 3. We can actually test this out. I will do console.log planets.length. Let me comment this, hit run. There you go. It's at 3. So that's the length of this array. So we're going to take advantage of that. So even if this increase in future, we don't care because we're getting the length and it will get added automatically. And then we'll do I++ to increase our index. So add our curly brackets. Now, same thing as last time, console.log. Now over here, if I do, let's say planets, what this will do is kind of print this out 3 times, the whole array. So let's test it out. So if you notice, it printed out Earth, Mercury, Jupiter 3 times over here. But this is not what we want. What we want is to print out the values, this thing, one by one. So we want to print out our Earth, then Mercury, then Jupiter in 3 separate lines. So to do that, just the way we were doing it before, we were doing planets bracket 0. So we were doing this, planets, and then adding the index over here. So we're going to take advantage of that. We'll do planets and index, since we are changing every time from 0 to 1 to 2, I will add I over here. So I'm doing planets and then adding I. If I hit run, there you go. We are printing out Earth, Mercury, Jupiter. And if I add something else, let's say Mars over here. And if I hit run again, there you go. Mars is also printing out here. So that's the most common use case you will see when working with loops. Now, there are different ways of loops to do in JavaScript. So we just looked at for loop. Another way to do this is called by doing something called a for off loop. So the way for off loop works is I'm going to do for. Here we will, just like last time, we'll create a variable. Let's say I create this for planets. I will call it P. I can name this anything. And this will, I will add over here for off. And then I will do planets. Same syntax as last time. And do console.log. Here I'm going to print out P. Now there you go. So we are printing out Earth, Mercury, Jupiter again. It's printing out twice because we have this over here too. If I hit run again, there you go. It's this four of them with that just got printed out now. So basically what we can do is take advantage, instead of doing this whole thing, if you want to do something easier, you can take advantage of for off loop. So for off takes an iterable. So what that means is anything like an array or a string, even that would work. So let's say if I change this from planets to a string, which is a string planet, and if I run this, there you go, it just printed out planets in each separate line. So we have P, LA, and ETS. So this way you can print out something that's an iterable. So you can have your array, your string, or some other iterable object. So we looked at for loop, we looked at for off loop. There's another that's called a for in loop. So the way for in loop works is it loops over an object or the property and the values of the object. So we looked at object previously too. We had this object created, which is the names. So if I put this over here, now let's say if you want to print out all the properties of this name object. So by properties, I mean name one, name two, and the values are Joe and Jay. So if I want to print this out, I can take advantage of the for in loop, which is kind of same as the for off loop. So the syntax is pretty much same. So I'm going to do for variable, and this time I'll do it name, call it, let's say n in names. And then here I will do console.log. And when I print out n, what it will do is print out the properties. If I hit enter, yep, there you go. So it printed out name one, name two. If I add in another one here, let's say name three. And this one, oops, and this one, if I add in, let's say Lisa, if I hit run, and it will also print out name three. Now, what if you want to print out the actual value? Well, you can do that pretty easily too. So I will do console.log, and here I will do names, and in the bracket I would add n. So n is like your index, right? So we can do names and then pass in n. If I hit enter, there you go. It printed out your Joe, Jane, Lisa. So this is another easy way where if you have an object, if you want to loop through the keys and the values of that object, you can do that through for in loop. All right, so I'm going to show you one more. Now, this one is something that we will be using in our code base later on. So I just want you to get familiar with it and see how that works. Now, similarly, I'm going to take advantage of the planets. I'm going to do planets dot. This time we're going to do for each. So we do for each. And in the bracket, we're going to create a function. Now, we haven't looked at function yet, but just bear with me here. So I'm going to create a function and then name this planet. And then over here, basically just print out planet. If I hit enter, there you go. So it just printed out our planets over here. Now, I know we haven't looked at function. We will cover that in the upcoming videos. But for now, basically what we are doing is we are doing a planet and then adding a for each. So anything that's an iterable, we add that, do a for each loop on that, create a function, assign any value here. It doesn't have to be planet. I can change this to, let's say, an I. And if I hit enter, well, even that would work. So it doesn't really matter what you put in here. So I just wanted to show you this since we will be covering in the upcoming videos. So we covered different types of for loops, or the commonly used one. What we didn't cover is another type of loop, which is called a while loop. So the way while loop works is, if I create while here, it takes an boolean condition, whether something is true or not. For example, if I do while I is less than 10, I'm going to do print out console.log I. So I'm saying, hey, while I is less than 10, print out the value of I. But one thing to keep in mind, if I hit run right now, my actual, the REPL would break because it will just keep infinitely looping over here because there's I value is always less than 10. So obviously we haven't defined a value here, but let's say if I do var I equals 0, in this case, I value is always less than 10. So this will infinitely keep looping, but we don't want that. So we're going to do I plus plus. So this is what we're saying. Keep increasing the value of I. And once the value reaches less than 10, in this scenario, let's say if it reaches 10, then just basically break out of this loop. So let's hit run over here and see if this works. Yep, there you go. So we just did 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, all the way till 9. So this way you can use another way of looping. If you don't want to use, let's say, for loop, you can take advantage of while loop. But most likely you will be using for loop like this. All right, so that was a quick intro to loops. So make sure to practice this on your own if you're not familiar with these concepts. I will add in some additional resources for you if you'd like to learn more about loops. And once you feel confident working with them, jump onto the next lecture and we'll move on to the next topic.